Hello guys, my name is John Shaibu from Lantop Infotech. In this tutorial, we are going to create a navigation bar using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. By the end of this tutorial, we are going to achieve this that you are seeing on my screen. It's going to have a link that is going to help people navigate from one page to another on our website. And it's going to have a call to action button and a button here. So let's get straight into it. For this tutorial, I am going to be using Visual Studio Code. And if you are not using Visual Studio Code, you can also use other text editors. Yeah, the main point is that you make sure. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using Visual Studio Code. You can use any text editor you like, and it will still work perfectly as you are seeing it here. So I will start with the HTML file. I've created the files already. I've created all the assets I'm going to using for this tutorial already. So you can, I'm going to start with the index file in the index.html file, which is what I am, which is the current file I am on. So I am going to start writing my code to. So I'm going to rename the title of our document to Navbar Tutorial. And I'm going to link it to our style sheet, which is style.css, the name of our file, style.css, and I'm also going to link it to our script tag. I'm going to link our script tag, script, which is script.js. So I'm going to start with the header tag. This header tag will be the parent tag of all other tags we are going to be using in this tutorial. So I'm going to start with an anchor tag, which is going to navigate to the navbar. Inside it is going to be an h1 tag, and let's look at what we have now. Let's refresh our page. So our content has start showing on the page already. So let's continue with our HTML files. So now I'm going to open a nav tag inside the same parent tag. So now I'm going to use a VS Code shortcut to create this. You can also achieve the same thing, but you can. I don't think other this shortcut can work in other text editors, but you can follow the same as the same tags. If you follow the same principle, you are going to achieve the same thing in this tutorial. So now, so what I did is that I created a nav tag. I opened a nav tag, but inside that nav tag, I created another list tag, and also inside the another list is the list item holding the links that will be used to navigate through our page. So the href for this, since it's just a demo, I'm just going to use this hash to as a test, and the target attribute is going to be top. So, and this is going to be the home. So I'm going to copy this and duplicate this 3 times. So this is going to be the about. The services, and the blog. After that, I'm going to open. Outside the nav tag, I am going to open an A tag, which is going to be for our call to action button. So the A is going to be for is going to have a class of CTA, which is a short form for call to action, and the href is also, because it's the demo, so I'm just going to use this hash for the href, and the target is also going to be top. Inside the A tag, I will also open the button tag. Which I'm going to name Get Started. So I think that's all for now for the desktop version. Later, when we are going to when we are adding our mobile version, our mobile menu, we can come back to edit our HTML file. So let's see what we have in our HTML file for now. So this is it, without any styling, without any CSS code. So now we are going to add to our VS Code and start adding our CSS code to it. So let's start with the CSS. First of all, I'm going to use this universal selector to select every item in every tag in our HTML file, and I'm going to set the box sizing to border box. Let me try to set it. After setting it to border box, I'm going to select the body tag body tag. And set the margin to 0 pixels, and the font, I'm going to use a font family I have installed on my Pixie already, which is Poppins. And I'm going to add a 4x font as Arial. So after setting that, we're going to select our header tag, which is the parent tag for all other tag in our code. And we are going to say we are using a display type called flex, a layout type called flex. So I'm going to set the display to be flex. And I'm going to justify content to be spaced between. And I'm going to align each item in it. Align items to be center. And the padding, I'm using a shutdown property instead of using a CSS shutdown property to write it. So this padding represents the top and the side, the top and bottom. This first value represents the top and bottom, and this second value represents the right side and the left side. So after that, I'm going to set the background color to our primary color. I'm going to set the background color to two, four, two, five. And after that, we add to our button. I'm going to select let's see what we have first in our code. So we were able to achieve this with what we've written so far. So let's continue. So now I'm going to select the button tag, the list items, and the A tag, and I'm going to set the font family to Poppins. The font width, to be 500. The font size, to be 1 em. The color, to be white. And the text decoration should be none. After done, let's look at what we have now. Can you see this? Okay. So let's move to this. This span tag is for to add a little bit of design to our logo, and I'm going to use our secondary color, which is this. After that, I'm going to select the class we used, the nav links. And I'm going to set the list type to be none. After then, I'm going to select the all list item under this nav link class. And I'm going to set the display to be inline block. And the padding should be 0 pixel by 10 pixels. And I'm also going to select all the A tag under this list item tag. And I'm going to set the transition. I want to add a little bit of effect to the so I'm going to a little bit of transition to I want to add a transition effect to the links. So whenever it's hovered upon, it's simultaneously change the color from one to another. So I'm going to be using this a shortened property for all 0.3 seconds is on 0 seconds, and so I'm going to add an over effect. I'm going to change the color, so whenever it's hovered upon, the color changes to this, our secondary color. So let's look at what we have now. So our navbar is not working okay. So let's continue with it. So let's tie the button. I'll set the padding. Nine pixels by 25 pixels. The background color I'm going to be using an RGBA value, which is going to start with 0, 136, 169, and 1, and the border is going to be none. The border radius is going to be 5 pixels, and the transition, I'm also adding a transition effect to this, all 0.3 seconds is 0 seconds, and also the cursor is going to be pointer. So let's look at it now. Is now looking okay, is now looking cool. So let's head back to our HTML code. And try to add, and let's try and let's design for the mobile version, because this design is meant for desktop versions alone. So let's design the mobile version of this navigation bar. First of all, we are going to be adding an image tag. And with a class, I'm going to name this class Open Menu. And this source of the image itself to be images, and this is going, I'm using this image I have already downloaded as to be my menu icon, and I'm going to add an alt attribute to be open menu. After that, outside the header tag, I'm going to create a div tag. I'm also going to use a shorthand property. So it's going to have a class of mobile menu, and also an ID of mobile menu as well. It's going to be a parent tag for an unordered list, a li tag, and an a tag. I'm just going to copy this because we are using the same thing for the mobile version as well. It's also going to have a call to action button of its own. So it's going to have a .cta mobile. It's going to have a class of CTA mobile, call to action mobile, and an href. Because it's a demo, when it's not linking to any other page. It's also going to have a target. Of top. Underscore top. And the name is going to be. Get started. I hope you can see our HTML page without the styling. So now that we've added a little bit of code, let's refresh our page. So everything has been added to the page. This is the icon I downloaded for the menu icon. So we are going to set it in seconds. So let's head back to our CSS code, our HTML code, while we start styling our CSS code. So we are going to start with the class dot open menu. Open menu. And we are going to set the width to be 100%. The display to be none. And we're also going to select this class. After selecting the image class, we've set the display, and we're also going to select the open menu, which is the div, the parent div holding all other tags. The mobile menu. And we're also going to set the width to be 100%. The background color. Be our secondary our primary color, and the padding should be 5 pixels, and the display. So by default, we are going to set the display to be none for desktop version. Later, when we are on mobile version, the display is now going to be shown. So for now, let's comment this display to be none to see the result of what of the code we've just written. So this is the result of the code we've just written. It looks good. It's still, so let's continue with the styling. So I'm going to, I want to remove the bullet on the on our links. So I'm going to select the mobile menu and the list item, and I'm going to set the list type to be none. And the margin should be 0 pixels. The padding should also be 0. So I'm also going to call we're going to set the padding to be 10 pixels by 8 pixels. There is a mistake here. Is this is supposed to be UL on under list. And after that, we are going to let's check the result of what we just written. So this is it, and this is our call to action button. Let's style our call to action button. The CTA mobile, the class we gave our call to action button, we are going to set the margin to 10 pixels by 0, the display should be blocked, the background color is going to be our secondary color, which is this. And we're also going to set the padding to be 10 pixels. And the border radius should be 5 pixels. And we're going to align the text to center. So let's check out our code again. So everything is looking nice now. So we are going to write the media query after designing the mobile version. And so we are going to write some media queries to balance it up. So we are starting this. The media query at media at media only screen. Only screen and we're going to set it for any device that is less pixels. So for any device that is going that is lesser than 600 pixels, the header, we are going to write the header is going to have a padding of 20 pixels and 5%, and the width is going to be 100%. So it's also going to have the call to action button. We are going to set it the display to be none. And the navigation bar also, we are going to set the display to be none. And the open menu that we've set the display to be none is going to be displayed block. The display, we are going to set the display to be block. So let's uncomment this. So let's refresh our page. There is a mistake here. This is supposed to be 30 pixels. And everything is okay now. So let's write a little bit of JavaScript to balance it up, because this is meant to be displaying the menu we designed, the mobile menu we designed the other time. So let's write a little bit of JavaScript. I've already outlined it out, so we can rewrite it. Let me delete this. So first of all, we are going to create a function, and we're going to name the function open menu. So after that, we are going to create a variable inside the function, and we are going to name the variable menu, and we are going to assign it to this. document.getElementById. So we are getting the ID we used the other time, which is mobile menu. So we are going to write an if statement. So we are going to write an else statement for you. So that is all we'll be writing in our JavaScript code. So now I'm going to copy this function and add to our HTML code and call this function. So I'm going to add an HTML event to it, which is going to be onClick. It's going to call this function. So whenever the user clicks on this icon we created, it's going to display our menu bar, the mobile menu we created. So let me refresh this. So our menu bar is now working perfectly. So let's try to adjust this. It's floating out of the page. Let's enter our CSS code. I don't know what's wrong. The problem is with the box sizing not adjusting. Let me try to delete this and write this. I don't know what the case may be, but whatever the case may be, I just hope it's working well over there in whatever test editor you are using. So it's showing here, I don't know why it's not working. I guess we have to leave it like this for now. So let me try on another device to see if it's work, if it works well. I'm not sure what is wrong. I guess the problem is with my test editor, but in any case, I just hope it's working well over there in whatever test editor you are using. So in case it's working well, you can let me know. So see you guys in the next tutorial.